morning everyone, how are you? Hope you all are healthy and fit at your place. So today we are here with a new day and a new video. The topic that based on our today's topic is the internet terminology. As we know that we have already discussed a lot of things like what is internet, advantages of disadvantage of internet, characteristics of internet. So today here in this video we will learn about some basic terminologies like www, web browser, web address, web server, protocols, HTTP and different things. So for further detailed knowledge about that, we will move to our slideshow screen. We will discuss about the topic internet and its terminologies, means the basic thing that we can use with the internet. So here our first topic is internet. Internet is a global system of interconnected computer networks that uses the standard internet protocol suite to serve billions of users worldwide. It is a network of networks that consists of millions of private, public, academic, business and government networks. This topic we have studied already, that internet is a network of millions of computers that all are connected to each other in order to share the data, information and the resources. The computers on the internet use remote server machines to share the files and devices with user machines. With the help of internet, we can review newspapers, magazines and books, we can listen the music, we can watch the movies, we can play the game, we can keep ourselves updated. By using the current events, we can go for the online shopping, we can know about the recipes, we can check the airline schedules, we can do the railway reservations for email facility, we can host the computer to the other devices and all. We can perform number of tasks by using the internet, because we know that nowadays internet plays a vital role in the society. Now, the next is uses of internet. First is email. It is the most vital area where we can use internet email. It at least 85% on the inhabitants of cyberspace send and receive the email facility, that is the email, electronic mail. Some 20 million email messages cross the internet every week. The second is in the field of research. We can also use the internet in the field of research. The next is to download the files. We can download number of files, like we can download the ebooks, we can download the magazines, we can download the audio video lectures, we can download the softwares, we can download the exe and apk files also. Now the next is discussion group. These include the public groups such as those on Usenet and the private mailing list that list manages. The next is for the interactive game. Today, number of online games are available for the entertainment purpose. We can download that directly from the internet. Some of the most popular games like PUBG, COC, Clash and Clan, Temple Run are there. Who hasn't tried to hunt down at least one game? And the field of education and the self-improvement. Today, the internet can be mainly used in the field of education and self-improvement. Number of online courses and workshops have found another outlet for the friendship and dating purpose. Today, over the internet, number of websites are available, number of softwares are available that can be used for the friendship purpose and for the dating purpose, like Tinder. You may also be surprised at the number of electronic personals that you can find on the World Wide Web. Like WhatsApp is there, Facebook is there, Instagram is there, Twitter is there, Tinder is also there for the dating and friendship app. The next is electronic newspaper and the magazines. This category includes the late breaking news, weather forecasting and for sports purpose. We are likely to see this category leap to the top 5 in the next several years. The next is job hunting. Classified ads are in the abundance, but most are for the technical positions. Means today number of jobs are available over the internet. We can just go to the website and find that out. That sarkaririzal.com, sarkarinaukri.com, number of websites are there. The next is in the field of shopping. It is difficult to believe that this category even ranks. It appears that the cyber malls are more curious than the serious shoppers. Means today, number of online shopping sites are available over the internet, like Flipkart, Amazon, Myntra, ShopClues, eBay and Peach Mode are also there. So we can do the online shopping. We are not, we do not waste our time to go to the market. We can just sit at our home, sit at our place in our luxury, and we can do the order online. The next is type of internet connectivity, means how we can connect our devices through the internet. Types of internet connectivity can be broadly categorized into two categories. Number one, the wired technology, and second is the wireless technology. In the field of wired technology, the first is dial-up connection. It uses the facilities of the public Swiss telephone network, means PSTN, to establish an internet connection via the telephone lines using a device called the modem. Means here in this we can connect our computer or our device by using the telephone line using a device called the modem. The full form of modem is modulator demodulator. Users dial a number and get the access to the internet. Dial-up connections are extremely slow in this speed. The next type is DSL. The full form is digital subscriber line. It provides the internet connectivity by transmitting the digital data over the wires of a local telephone network. It enables the use of telephone and data transmission on a single telephone line. For using the DSL connection, we need a DSL modem, that is digital subscriber line modem, and a subscription charge. The next is cable internet access. It is a form of broadband internet access that uses the cable TV infrastructure. It is provided through the existing cable TV network, and it is just similar to the DSL, that is your digital subscriber line. The next type of technologies are the wireless technology. These technologies follow the waves, that like radio waves, infrared, and number of different types of waves, so with the data or the signals can be transmitted. Number first is WiMAX. The full form of WiMAX is Worldwide Interoperability for the Microwave Access. It is a wireless communication standard that is designed to provide the mobile broadband connectivity across the cities and the countries through the variety of devices. It is a long-range system. It is beneficial where there is a difficulty in laying out cables and wires. So it is a totally wireless connection. The speed of WiMAX is much more higher, and the range area is bigger than the Wi-Fi. The next type of wireless technology is 3G. 3G means it is short for the third generation. It is a set of standards used for mobile devices and mobile telecommunication services and networks. If the phone supports 3G, then the higher speed internet connectivity can be accessed through its subscription. The next technology is Wi-Fi. The full form of Wi-Fi is wireless fidelity. It is a popular technology used to transmit or to transfer the data wirelessly over a particular network. Wi-Fi stands for wireless fidelity. The wireless network is formed through a device called the wireless access point, that is the WAP. It is beneficial as there is no need of laying out wires for transferring the data. Here in this picture, you have seen that how to connect the internet, how we can connect our device by the internet. The telephone line is also there, broadband MTA router is there, DSL cable modem, and the internet connection. It all passes through a particular sequence and through which our internet, our system get connected with the internet. The next is internet services or the terminologies of internet. So here, the few services are like www. The full form of www is World Wide Web, web page or the home page, web publishing, web browser, search engine, protocols, internet protocol, DNS, that is your domain name server, HTTP means the hypertext transfer protocol. The first service is www, the World Wide Web. It is commonly known as the web. It is a system of interlinked hypertext and hypermedia documents accessed via the internet. The World Wide Web, commonly known as the web, it is an information system where documents and other web resources are identified by the URL, that is the Uniform Resource Locator. It is also called the address. Sir Tim Berners-Lee invented the World Wide Web in 1989. So, World Wide Web is a collection of web pages over the internet or around the world. These documents are available on the internet and contain a variety of resources such as text, audio, graphics, video, and multimedia, etc. The next is web browser. A web browser is the software that used to view the websites and acts as an interface between the user and the World Wide Web. First web browser was developed in 1991, Mosaic developed by Mars Anderson. So, a web browser is an application software that provides the user to easily access the internet. It works as an interface between the user and the World Wide Web. If a user want to search anything, then they can just access the internet by using a source called the web browser, or it is used to interpret the web pages. A web browser enables the user to request for web pages from a web server and view the request web pages on their computer screen. The commonly used web browsers are Microsoft Internet Explorer, Mozilla Firefox, Netscape Navigator, Apple, Safari, Google Chrome. So, here are the pictures of that some of the special web browsers like Opera Mini is there, Google Chrome, Safari, Netscape Navigator, Internet Explorer, Microsoft Edge, and Mozilla Firefox. The next service is website. A website, also written as website, it is a collection of web pages and related content that is identified by a common domain name and published on at least one web server. A website is a collection of related material that contains the text, image, and may also include the video, audio, or other media. A website is just like a book. A book contains number of pages, same as a website contains the number of web pages that holds large amount of information and reside on a single server. Various types of websites are available on the internet, such as educational websites, commercial websites, jobs and career websites, entertainment websites. The first web page that is displayed when you access the website is called the home page. A website can contain the information about any particular organization, about any particular commercial, any particular entrepreneurship, any particular company at all. So here you have seen in the figure that this is the website of our school, that Arden Progressive School. www.ardenlamachaw.com is the domain, or it is the URL of this website. The next is web page. A web page is a simple document displayable by a web browser. Such documents are written in the HTML languages. A web page may contain text, graphics, and hyperlinks to the other web pages and files. The internet consists of millions of web pages, with more being added every day. Or it is also known as the page. A web page may include text, hotlinks, videos, audios, graphics. The web page on the internet allows us to quickly move to the another web page. We can just by clicking on a particular hyperlink, commonly known as link. A web page is a single electronic page that allows the user to find out the information about any particular topic and about any particular thing. Here you have seen, suppose if we want to find any of the web page about any of the particular topic, then we have to simply write it along with the keyword, then we will get number of web pages. The next is protocol. Protocol means a set of guidelines or the rules. Each and every organization must have their protocols and rules that an employee has to follow. Same as if we want to transmit the data over the internet, then we will use a protocol or the set of rules. These are the formats that agree to transfer the data between two devices. Number one, some of the protocols are HTTP, Hypertext Transfer Protocol, IP, Internet Protocol, FTP, File Transfer Protocol, SMTP, Simple Mail Transfer Protocol, NNTP, Networks News File Transfer Protocol, TCP, Transmission Control Protocol, normally used together with the Internet Protocol, that is the IP. The next service is blog. A blog is a discussion-style site used by the non-technical users for creating the personal web pages. Or it is an area where a user can show or user can share their thoughts and views over the internet. It can be used by the technical users. It can be used to create their personal web pages. A blog is similar to an online personal diary and similar to use. It is used to convey the messages, events, news, announcement, etc. Service, some of the example of websites that offer the blog services like www.blogger.com. This one is the URL where we can get the blog, number of blog sites. www.wordpress.com. WordPress is also used to create the websites and web pages. Weebly.com, www.blog.com. Now, the next is hyperlink. Hyperlink is also called the link. It is a link that redirects us or that on clicking redirects us to the another web page. Alternatively, referred to as a link and web link. A hyperlink is an icon, graphic or the text that links to the another file or object. A hyperlink points to a whole document or to a specific element within a document. Hypertext is the text with hyperlink. The text that is linked from is called the anchor tag. Or hyperlink means a web page contains highlighted text or images called the hyperlink. By clicking on these links, you can move from one page to another. You can easily identify a hyperlink on a web page as it appears with an underline and usually in blue in color. The next is, what is URL? The full form of URL is Uniform Resource Locator. It is probably most easily described as a web address. URL and web address are often used interchangeably. It is a complete web address used to find a particular web page. Here, the examples of URLs are, number one, www.yahoo.com. The second is www.google.com. Here, HTTP is the protocol that allows to transmit the data or to transfer the data. www.yahoo.com and google.com, these both are the domain name, and these whole makes a URL, that is your uniform resource locator. The URL denotes the global address of the web document and the web resources. Internet communication is the main reason for identifying a resource on the web. This communication between a web user and the internet resource is possible by identifying the each resource on the internet in a standardized manner that can be done by the URL. The next is domain name. A domain name is a unique name that is assigned to a website. The website or the web page over the internet has the particular own domain name. Two websites can never have the same domain name. It can be a unique one. No two websites on the internet can use the same domain name because each domain name is unique. This enables anyone to access your website using the domain name. If you didn't have a domain name, the only way anyone could access your website is by using the IP address, that is your internet protocol address. Or it is all the domain name system is a system in which the domain names are matched with the IP address, since the internet works only with the IP address. So suppose a user from India wants to use the yahoo.com search engine, then the person will simply type www.yahoo.co.in into the web browser and press the enter key. The user's ISP will query their domain name server and find the unique IP address associated with the yahoo.co.in portion, thus directing the network traffic to the IP address. The next is web server. A web server is a computer that stores the website and their related files for viewing on the internet. The basic objective of web server is to store, process and deliver the web pages to the users. The intercommunication is done by using a special protocol called the Hypertext Transfer Protocol. So web server can be any computer program which delivers web content by using the HTTP. It can be a computer or a virtual machine which runs program for delivering the web content. The next is IP address. An IP address is a unique address that identifies a device on the internet or a local network. Every device that connects on the network has their own IP address, or each device assigned to a particular IP address through which they can participate in the network, and they are allowed to share the data and the information, and they can be able to work. IP stands for Internet Protocol, which is the set of rules governing the format of data sent via the internet or the local network. An IP address is a string of numbers separated by the periods. These are expressed as a set of four numbers. An example of address might be 192.158.1.38. Each number in the set can range from the 0 to 25. Here period means the full stop or the dot. So the full IP address ranges goes from 0.0.0.0 to 255 to 255 means the maximum limit. So the IP address consists a unique set of numbers which is provided to each computer by IETF. It avoids the transmission and connection error. The IP address is 32-bit numeric address containing a set of four numbers which varies from 0 to 25. Now, the IP address must be in the 64-bit format, numeric address format, the new IP address. The next is search engine. Search engine allows the user to search the data while they are working with the internet or the www. Search engine allows users to search the internet for content using the keywords. Means if any user want to search something over the internet, first they have to access the web browser, any of the web browser of their choice. After that, they have to type like www.google.com, www.yahoo.com, AOL, Bing. Number of search engines are there. So if they want to find out any particular topic, then they have to write the keywords for that. A search engine is a web-based tool that enables the user to locate the information on the World Wide Web. Popular examples of search engines are Google, Yahoo, and Amazon Search. Here, you have seen the images of the search engine like Google, Yahoo, Bing, Baidu, Ask, AOL, DuckDuckGo, Ecosia, Archive, Yandex. The next is search directory. It is similar to the yellow pages and the first book. In the phone book, a source directory is categorized as the online index of the website. When we are talking about the indexing of website online, then that is called the search directory. Unlike search engine, which use web crawlers to visit the websites and collect the data for indexation, source directories are populated through the processes of the application and the approval. Now, the search directories, these are the most beneficial term that that can be used over the internet. These are just like the yellow pages in the phone book. Here you have seen the example of the search directories, DOMS, D-M-O-Z. Before the search engine like Google become popular, web directories or the search directories were used. It can be used earlier. Nowadays, most search directories are no longer in use. As the name implies, web directories are directories where an anonymous connection of links to the site arranged in the different categories are stored. The site in the web directory are listed mostly in the alphabetically order, and users can browse the data through that. Students, that's all about today's information. If you have any query, any doubt related to you can ask me, you can directly call me, you can WhatsApp me, or you can drop a message in the Dropbox. And one more thing, that you have to complete your work on time and send it to me. Thank you. Have a nice day.